You don't have class, right? After this? So I will finish this day. I will finish this slide. Alright. So go to slide presentation. Okay. So site investigation, eh? So as a civil engineer or geotechnical engineer, okay, before you do all the design, yeah, you need to have the borehole. You need to do the borehole and you need to have a bollock, yeah, to design your foundation, design your retaining structure, yeah. So you need the SI. You need to do the SI, site investigation, to get the information lah, yeah, the soil parameter, yeah, to design for your structure, yeah, geotechnical structure. All right. So, what is site investigation? Yeah, so you do the site investigation is the to get the borehole lah, to do the borehole and get the bollock. Yeah, I will show you the bollock later on. Yeah, so from the bollock you can use the result, yeah, the SPTN value to start design lah for your structure. All right. Okay, and then boring is borehole lah. You do the borehole. Okay, I will show you later on. Okay, and then when you do the SI, okay, you can get the sample. Okay, you can do the sampling and then go to the lab and do lab test lah. Okay, like the one you do in the geotechnical lab. So you can get the parameter, yeah, the C, the free value and whatever parameter that you need lah for your design. Okay, you as an engineer have to determine what type of what sort of test that you need for your design, yeah, the parameter and yeah, that you can get from all the tests, yeah. So you as an engineer, you have to determine yourself lah. All right, and then field testing. Okay, if you have a problem, yeah, to do the boring, so then you can do the in situ test lah, meaning that you bring the you collect the sample and do the test on site. Okay, and then the lab testing lah, here the lab testing. All right. Okay, so in a site investigation, okay, usually normally we will do the standard penetration test. Okay, from the standard penetration test you can get the value. All right, the SPTN value, so that you can use for in your design. By example, the foundation design, yeah, retaining wall, retaining structure. So you need the SPTN value, yeah. All right. Okay. So this is the example, yeah. This is the photo, yeah, of the standard penetration test. Okay, standard penetration test, SPT, yeah, right. Okay, student, if you have any question, just ask, yeah, on your mic and ask. All right. Okay, so this one is the equipment lah, that they use, that the contractor use in the SI, site investigation, yeah. So this is the equipment. Sometimes if you pass through the construction area, so you can see this equipment on site. So they are doing SPT test. Yeah. So anyone of you see this equipment on site? Anyone?
No.
So so this is one of the photo lah. So you can go through YouTube. You go to YouTube and search. Yeah. So it's more clearer lah. This one. Alright. Okay. So this is the bohol. Yeah. Meaning that soil. Then they do the bohol. Yeah. To get the to do the SPT. And SPT test and prepare for the bolok lah. Yeah. So after they do the borehole, they have to mark the borehole location like this. Yeah. Here. They have to mark lah the borehole location. Yeah. So that when the engineer, yeah, the designer come go to the site, they will they can know the exact location of the borehole. Yeah, all right. Okay, so when they do the SPT test, yeah, usually the engineer will ask the contractor to take a photo as a proof like this. So they have project name, okay, and the dates, yeah. And the borehole number, yeah, so that you can have a proof that the contractor really do the SI, not just take from any result from other test and submit to you. So you have a proof lah, yeah. At least you have a proof that they are doing the SI for you. All right. Okay. Any questions so far? Student, any question?
No.
Because as a technical engineer, this one is the main thing, yeah? That you have to understand, you have to know, yeah? For your design as a geotechnical engineer. So when you want to design a foundation, yeah, you want to design your retaining structure, so you need the borehole and the bolok, the result. Okay, so I want you to know, really understand the term. Eh? So bolok, yeah, bolok is the result that you get from the test lah, SPT test. Yeah. Oops. SPT test. Yeah. SPT test, you do the borehole kan? Borehole is the hole lah. Yeah? That you do on site. Yeah? So bolok is the result like this. Yeah? Yeah, as shown in the screen. Yeah? So they have two bolok. One is uncorrected bolok. Another one is the corrected bolok. So what is the difference between the two? Okay? So for the uncorrected bolok is the bolok that handwriting, yeah, which is handwriting, yeah, on the description. Here there's a description, yeah, on the soil, yeah. So the description is given or prepared by the geologist. So during the SI, they do the SPT test. The geologist and also the civil engineer has to be there, yeah, to supervise the project. And for the geologist, they have to give the description lah on the soil, yeah. When they do the SPT test, they collect the sample, okay, sample out. So from the sample, the geologist have to define the soil. So it will written here lah. Yeah. All right. And then the depth is the depth of the borehole. Okay. And then this one is the name of the soil sample. Okay. And then this is the SPT test value lah. Yeah. The blue count. This one is the blow count. Yeah. Okay. Okay, so this is the, here is the SPT and value. Okay, so this is the value that you need for your substructure design. Okay, so substructure meaning that structure below the ground, eh, is substructure. Alright, okay, superstructure is the structure above the ground. Okay, so this is, that is the term that you need to know lah. Okay, so the connected bollock is the bollock that you get after the lab test. Yeah, so after lab test, they will check lah whether the description given by the geologist is correct or not. Yeah, so they will compare and with the and read along with the lab test lah. Yeah, so we will do the correction here lah. Yeah, all right. Okay, so we come out with the corrected bollock. Okay, so as an engineer, sometimes you have time constraint to do your design. Okay, so you can after your contractor do the SI, you can straight away call them and ask them to email to you or email or submit to you lah the corrected bollock. So you can design your foundation or your retaining wall based on the uncorrected bollock first. Okay, and after usually after normally after 1 month lah, they after they do the apa tu, they do the lab test. Okay, they come out with the corrected bollock. Okay, so you have to check back lah your design with the corrected bollock, is it okay? Yeah, all right. So that is how the engineers works lah. Yeah, in the real industry. Okay. All right. So I hope it's clear until now. If you have question, just ask. Yeah. Okay. And then this one, I want to see whether it is recorded or not. Okay. All right. So okay, this is the example of the bollock. Okay, so as I mentioned, that the depth here is the depth of the borehole. Yeah, it start from zero lah. Zero is the ground level, zero. So zero to 1.5. So that is how they read the depth of the borehole. Okay, and then this is the distribution on the soil itself. Yeah, so you can look at here lah, the distribution of the soil. Because when they do the SPT test, they collect the sample out, kan? So this is the distribution on the sample itself. Okay, and then this is the depth of the each of the sample. This is the sample number. That is the location where they collect the sample. Okay, is it clear? Okay, the depth here is the depth where they collect the sample. This is number, sample number here. Eh? Same lah. Yeah, this one is the continuous of the bollock. Yeah, so here is the number of the sample. Okay, and then this is the depth, the location where they collect the sample. Okay, I hope it's clear. Eh? Clear, right? Hello, Len.
Yes.
Are you with me?
Yes, I do.
Okay, if you have question, just ask. Eh? Don't wait after the class. All right? Okay, so this is the SPT test value. Lah, yeah? SPT, and we call it SPTN value. Okay, so this way, this is the, when they do the test, can, okay, that this one is the blower, yeah, meaning that So they blow lah, yeah. Each of the blow, it counts here, yeah. All right. So okay. So the tube kan, to collect the sample, yeah, to do the SPT test, the length, yeah. There's a tube kan, when they do the like this, a tube, yeah. So this is the hammer, okay. Where if you pass through the construction, when they do the test kan, you will heard the sound lah, yeah, the tang tang, the blow, the blow count, yeah. So so this is the apa tu, the sample, the core, yeah. Okay, so it will put a mark lah at every 75 mm, yeah, here. So this is the tube, yeah. All right, so it will put every mark every 75 mm. Yeah, so the length of the tube is 450, okay. So every time, yeah, they knock, yeah, they blow, okay, it will count the blow count lah. So this one, yeah, for each when the tube, yeah, insert to the ground, yeah, they will count lah how many blow, okay. So they will put here, and then so because this one is the length is 450, so they will have like 1, 2, 3, 4, the six, yeah, six range here. Yeah, so for the two, for the first two is not consider to calculate the SPTN value. Yeah, it will consider last four, yeah, the value. So by example here, the last four blow count is 5, 7, 7, 9. So plus together, then you add it together, then you get the SPTN value, SPTN value is 20, all right? The reason why they don't take into account the first two reading, because when they do, they insert and they install the tube, eh? It is not stable yet. Yeah, so that's why they don't consider lah the first two reading. Yeah, it will consider last four reading. Yeah, for the SPTN value. Yeah, so I hope it's clear lah. All right. Okay. So there will be the termination criteria. Okay, meaning that when you gonna stop your test, okay. Usually when you get the 50 blow lah, yeah, 5 times, meaning that the reading here, yeah, by example here, you get the SPTN value here, yeah, 5 times, yeah. So you can stop your SPT test lah. So that is the termination criteria. Yeah, meaning that when you going to stop your test lah, is the termination criteria. So usually for the geotechnical design, yeah, you will ask the contractor, the termination criteria is 5 times SPTN value, meaning that the contractor have to get 5 times SPTN 50, only then they can stop the test. Is it clear? I hope it's clear, isn't it? Okay tak? Hello student.
Yes, clear, clear.
Okay. So this is the tube that I mentioned to you just now. That I draw the length, yeah, is 450. Oops. The length, yeah, is 450 mm. All right. So each of the it will put the mark lah at every 75 mm. Yeah. So this is the sample that collected lah from the test. Yeah. So because you have to determine the sample recovery. Sample recovery meaning that how much sample that you collect from the test. Yeah. So each of the test is 450 mm. So you have to know the recovery ratio lah. Yeah. So how much sample that you collect, how many percent of the sample that you collect from the test. Yeah. By example here, to calculate the sample recovery is the length of the soil, yeah, divide by the sample length. Yeah. So the total length, yeah, the tube is just now is 450. So the length, sample length is 450 lah. Okay. So the length of soil sample here. So you measure lah the length of the soil sample. Okay. So you substitute length of the soil sample in this equation. Okay. Then you get the percentage of the sample recovery, meaning that how much the percentage of the soil that collected from the test. Alright. Okay. So the purpose of you are doing this one, yeah. So usually, normally, if you do the you want to do the test, kan? Yeah, the lab test, the sample, the minimum sample should be the length, yeah, should be more than 100 mm. Only then you can bring the sample to the lab and to do the lab test. Yeah, if the recovery ratio is low, so you cannot do the lab test. So that is the reason why we calculate for the sample recovery. All right. Okay. So this is the empirical value for the soil. Yeah. So for the cohesive soil, yeah, is the if the this is the range lah for the SPT N value. Yeah. All right. So if the SPT N value, the range is 0 to 2, so the soil is considered very soft. Yeah. So if the soil the SPT N value more than 30, meaning that the soil is hard. Yeah. Okay. So for non-cohesive soil, okay. So this is the SPT N value lah. So this is the relative density, the density of the soil. Yeah. Alright. So this is the range of the cyan angle. Oh no. This one is the C lah. The C value. Yeah. This one is the C cohesion. This one is the friction angle. Yeah. Alright. Actually, this one you can get from the lab test lah. Alright. Okay, if you because of sometimes the lab test is take like 1 month, kan? So you can use the range first, yeah, to design for your retaining structure, for example, yeah. And then after you get the corrected bolok, the full SI report from the contractor, only then you revise back your design lah. So this is how they practice in the industry. Yeah. Okay. So this is another bollock. Yeah. With the rock strata. Okay. So you can see here, there's a limestone. Yeah. Meaning that underground there's a limestone. So they have a rock strata. Yeah. Different from this example. Yeah. There's no rock. Yeah. Until the end of the test, yeah, there's no rock. Meaning that the rock may be really deep inside. So determination criteria will be this one lah. 5 times the SPTN value here. Yeah, they get 5 times SPTN value. Alright. So that's the difference between the these two bolok lah. Yeah. So for this one, there's a rock. Rock underground. Yeah. There's a bedrock lah. Yeah. Underground. Okay. So because this one, yeah, when you design for the your pile, yeah, when you design for that, okay, you have to look at the soil strata, yeah, to choose the type of pile that you're going to use for your structure, yeah. If because we have so many types of pile in available in the industry, so you have to choose which pile that suit your soil strata. Yeah, by example, if you have rock strata, okay, you can use span pile, because if you use span pile, yeah, when the pile you install the pile in the rock strata, the pile will break because you cannot insert the rock strata, yeah, for span pile. So if you have rock strata, so you have to choose bore pile or non-displacement pile lah, yeah, bore pile or micro pile, yeah. So that's why when you design for your foundation, yeah, you need the SI, yeah, as I mentioned, you need the SI, you need the bollock like this in order to proceed with your design. Okay, all right. So the if your soil strata, yeah, have a rock, so you will get the reading lah for your rock, yeah, strata. Okay, so this is the legend, yeah, the legend for the rock. Okay, and then this is the depth where the sample here is collected. Yeah, so this is the this one is the depth of your borehole. Yeah, so here is the depth location, location depth of your of the sample. Yeah, meaning that the location of the sample lah. Yeah, meaning that C1 is collected at the depth between 22.3 to 23.8. yeah, all right. So this one, the value that you need, yeah, to design for your bore pile is the RQD value, meaning that the strength of your rock, because for the for your bore pile, yeah, if by example this is your bore pile, yeah, if you install your bore pile, yeah, this is the ground level, yeah, this is your bore pile, oops. Okay, so you, for the bore pile, you have to, this one is your rock level lah, yeah. Okay, so this is the rock. So you have to socket, yeah, socket your pile in the rock, yeah. This is the your this is your socketed rock lah. Yeah, a socketed pile in rock. Yeah, this one socketed pile in rock. Yeah, meaning that your spun pile have to socket in the rock lah. If there's a rock strata, so you have to socket your pile in the rock. Yeah. So to calculate, to design for this one, you have to know the strength of your rock. Yeah. So you have to calculate the rock quality designation value. Yeah. So how to calculate this one? Using this figure lah. This equation. Yeah, use RQD equation. So RQD equal to total length of sound core pieces over total core length. Total core run length. Yeah, time 100. Yeah. So what is total core length? Is this one? Yeah. Meaning that the tube to collect the rock strata, the rock sample is the length of the tube to collect the rock sample is 1.2 meter. Here, 1.2 meter. Okay? Alright? So this is the example of the tube lah. Or don't have the figure. Never mind. The core length is the same lah, like this, but it's more thicker is thicker compared to the soil tube lah. Yeah. Okay. So this one length of sound core pieces, meaning that here you have to consider the core length more than 100 mm. Okay, by example here, this is the core length the core length, this is the rock sample lah from the coring. So the core in the rock strata. Okay, so you get this one. You get the sample like this. Okay, so for the sound core, so you consider the core length. Yeah, is more than 100. By example here, the first core length is 250. Okay, and then you check lah where the core length more than 100. So by example here, first one is 250. Yeah, so this one is damaged already, and so zero. This one is cannot consider lah because it's highly weighted. Yeah, so the core length is zero also. So this one, the sound, meaning that the perfect, the perfect sample, the length should be more than 100. So here, 190, and then this one cannot consider because less than 100 mm. Okay, so, and then this one lah, 200. So you solve this one, so you get the RQD value lah, this percentage. Okay, so from the RQD value, the percentage of RQD value, rock quality designation, so you can get the quality of your rock. If the RQD value between 0 to 25, the rock is very poor, very poor. Yeah, meaning that the rock is weak lah. Yeah, if you get the RQD value between 75 to 90, meaning that the quality of your rock is good. Yeah, so you when you design for your socketed length, maybe you have to socket not much lah in the rock, because you have good quality of rock. Yeah, so that's why you have to know how to calculate the rock quality designation lah. Yeah, the percentage of RQD is more important to you when you design for your part, your bore part or your micro part. Yeah. Any questions so far? Student, are you with me? Any question? Atau short sendiri je saya?
We are listening.
Okay. I hope it's clear, eh? Alright. Okay. Okay, this is the tube lah to collect the sample just now. Yeah. So this step sample, this is the tube lah. Yeah. Okay, it call it split spoon lah. The core. We call it split spoon. Yeah. Alright. So this is, you can read here lah description of the tube. Yeah. So the size, yeah, is 50 mm outer diameter and T8 inner diameter. Yeah. Okay. All right. So sample length. All right. And then this is the tube. Yeah. To collect for the undisturbed sample. Yeah. So you can see lah. The photo here. Yeah. Okay. One thing, when you collect for your undisturbed sample, yeah. So at the end, yeah, at the edges here, yeah. Yeah. Each of the edges of your tube, you have to put vaxing. Yeah. Lilin, you put vac on inside to make sure the moisture of your soil is not changed lah because of the weather. Yeah. Alright. So that's why you put the vaccine. Yeah. At the end edges of your tube. Yeah. For the undisturbed sample. Yeah. You have to the contractor have to make sure the sample condition is the same as they are collected in the on the site. Yeah. Okay. We don't want the sample to be disturbed by the lah. So that's why they put vaccine lah. Yeah. Okay. As a civil engineer or geotechnical engineer, okay, when you get the uncorrected bolok from the contractor, okay, so you have to prepare for the lab testing schedule. Yeah. Okay, so the lab testing schedule, the purpose of preparing the lab testing schedule is you as an engineer, you have to determine what sort of lab test that you need for your design. Different lab tests give you different parameter lah. Okay, by example, if you want to design a retaining structure, okay, then you need the C and the V value in. So you ask the contractor to do the soil strength test for you lah. So you tick here at the you undisturbed sample UD. So you tick so that the contractor know. Okay, you want the contractor do the soil strength test or whatever test here lah. You just tick. Yeah, ask the contractor to do any test for you for your this that you need for your design lah. Yeah. So as a geotechnical engineer or CNS engineer, so you have to prepare for the lab testing schedule lah. So this is the one of the example of the lab testing schedule. Yeah. Okay. So obtain from the lab test. Okay. So this is the parameter lah. Example of the parameter that you can get from the lab test. Yeah. So for the C and the V value, yeah, So you can get from Treasure Test or Shearbox Test. The one that you do in the class, yeah, direct shear test. Okay? To get the C and the fee value, yeah? In lab 3, right? You do the direct shear test. Okay? The purpose is to get the C and the fee value. All right? And then from the classification test, okay, you can get this parameter. All right? So this is the some example on the soil material parameter that you can get from the lab test. Excuse me, I want to drink water. Okay. Okay, you can have a cup of coffee during the class, your own. All right. So this is the summary of the this is the summary of the test result. Okay, so for the borehole number one, okay, so this is the depth of the sample, this is the sample number, this is the depth, and this is the test that you ask the contractor to do for you. Okay, so this is the value lah from the lab test. Okay, so you can refer here for your design. Yeah, all right. Okay, JKR prop test. Okay, if you have budget constraint, yeah, you can, because sometime in the project you have a budget constraint, and you cannot have so many bollocks, so many borehole for your project. Okay, because one borehole you like more or less 20,000 ringgit for one borehole, and it's very expensive, right? So you cannot have so many borehole for your project. Okay, so the alternative that you can use is you can use the prop lah. There has two prop available in Malaysia. One is the JKR prop. If you doing the JKR project, then you have to use JKR prop lah. If you design or you do for the commercial project, you can go to you can use Macintosh prop. Yeah, okay, so that's why we have two prop here lah. Yeah, one is JKR prop, one is Macintosh prop. Okay, so if you have constraint, budget constraint, okay, so you can use borehole as an alternative to get the SPTN value, because you can convert the MP test value to the SPTN value. Yeah, that's a table. Yeah. There's an equation also. I will show you in the next slide. Yeah. Okay. So this is the equipment. Yeah. Here, this is the equipment that JKR prop lah, or Macintosh prop equipment. So more or less the equipment is like this. Okay. Actually, we have the equipment in our lab. Yeah. Like a previous semester, I will bring the student to the site and do the Macintosh prop. So the student will have the experience to do the MP test lah, Macintosh test on site. But for your in our situation now, so we don't have the opportunity lah to use the equipment. Okay, but you can go to the YouTube. There's so many video on the Macintosh prop itself. So you can go through the video lah to know how they do the prop. Okay, the MP test. Yeah. Okay, MP is the Macintosh lah. Yeah. Macintosh prop MP. Yeah. Okay. So this is the this one is the hammer lah, yeah, this one hammer, and this is the drop fall. Yeah, because you have to pull the hammer and drop. Yeah, so the pull and drop. So this is the drop height lah. Yeah, 28. Yes, is the drop height. Yeah. Okay. So and then this is your rod lah. All right. Okay. The rod length is 1.2 meter. Okay. Okay. What is the difference between JKR prop and Macintosh prop? Okay. The difference is the cone itself. Yeah. The cone of the rod. Yeah. This is the rod. Yeah. So at the end, yeah, there's a cone to penetrate on the soil. Yeah. So this one is the angle. The difference is the angle. Yeah. For the JKR prop, the angle is bigger compared to Macintosh prop. All right. And the diameter is the same. Yeah. Diameter of the cone. Yeah. Diameter of the cone. Yeah. Okay. For the diameter of the rod, yeah, itself is different between JKR prop and the Macintosh prop. Yeah. So this is the difference. Lah. All right. And the weight of hammer. Just now, yeah, this hammer, yeah, is different between the JKR prop and the Macintosh prop, yeah, yeah. So this is the difference is about 0.5 kg lah, okay. And the drop height here, yeah, is different also, okay. For the JKR prop is 28, for the Macintosh prop is 30, yeah. So that is the only difference between the two props, okay? Okay, so for the limitation of the Macintosh prop, okay? So you can test, you only can test for the shallow depth, yeah? Maximum 50 meter, all right? But for the borehole, you can go up to 60 meter, yeah, it's up to you until you get the rock strata, for example. But for the Macintosh prop, there's a limitation. Yeah, maximum depth is 15 meter. If you want to go more deeper in the ground, so you have to do the borehole lah. Yeah, but if you want, if you plan, you plan or you only have like two-story building, okay? You can, you're not necessary to you to have a borehole. You can go for Macintosh prop, yeah? Because for the two-story building or one-story building, usually the engineer will use the pad footing, yeah, for the foundation. So you don't need to have, you don't need to go for borehole lah. You can do MP test for your project. Okay. So not for gravity ground. So because the rod cannot penetrate in the gravity ground, lah. It will tilt. Yeah. Okay. So human count. Okay. When you do the MP, so there's a blow, eh? You need to count the blow of the hammer. Okay, sometimes it will wrong counting lah. It will wrong counting and non-consistent drop height. Yeah, because you have to like pull and release the hammer. Kan? Maybe you cannot have the consistent drop height lah. Yeah, and exerted force to the drop hammer. Okay, when you do the MP test, you pull the hammer, eh? And then you release it. Sometimes you will exert the force. Yeah. To the hammer. Yeah. So that is the human error lah when you do the MP test. Okay, and then misleading result at the greater depth lah. So sometimes when you read the reading, kan, the reading should be like already at 1.5 meter. Eh? But you still count at 1 meter, by example. So misleading result at the greater depth. Eh? So you miss the apa? The counting, yeah, and also the depth of your test, lah, yeah. Okay, so as I mentioned, the termination criteria is the where to stop the test, yeah. So when you get the 300, okay, the blue one, if you get the maximum, 400 blue, per 300 mm, okay. Meaning that when you have 1 feet, yeah, you blow, okay, the maximum, you get the blown maximum blow number 400, so you can stop your test, lah. Or the depth of the test is 15 meter, okay. So that is the termination criteria, lah. Yeah. Meaning that when your reading is achieved 400 blow per 300 mm, okay, you can stop your test. Yeah, so that is the criteria, termination criteria. Okay, so precaution, you have to make sure it's free fall lah, and consistent drop height. Yeah, okay, and you have to oil and wash and oil your equipment after you use the equipment. Yeah, so your equipment won't corrode. Yeah. Because it's steel, kan? It's made from steel. So you have to make sure you wash and oil properly lah, so your equipment won't corrode. Yeah. Okay. So this is the example of the MP test. Yeah. So here, this is the number of blow. All right. So this is the depth. Yeah, so maximum is 15 meter, as I said. Yeah, so when you get the blow count, it's 400 mm, so you can stop your test. Yeah, so now 400 blow, so it stops the test, lah. All right, meaning that you already get the height strata. All right, okay, relation between SPT and value, okay, MP. And the bearing capacity. Okay. When you design for your pad footing, or later on you design for your mat foundation, okay, you have to check for the bearing capacity. Eh? So you need the bearing capacity value to check the, to get the FOS for your foundation. Okay. So you have to know the correlation, the relation between SPT and MP and the bearing capacity. Okay, so this is the actually I get from the when I'm working with JKR, I get the this one, the empirical value for soil. So you don't have to calculate. Actually, there's a equation here. Yeah, when you have the SPTN value and number of blow here, yeah. So you can substitute into this equation, then you can get the SPTN value, yeah, for your design. Okay, so you can convert. If you have, you do, that's why, as I mentioned, if you have the budget constraint to do the borehole, okay, so you can convert. You can do MP test lah, instead of borehole. Because one borehole costs you RM20,000, but one MP test costs you like RM2,000 only. So there's a huge difference, yeah, on the price. Yeah. So if you have budget constraint, you cannot have so many numbers of borehole. So you can use MP test, lah. Okay. And then you can convert the MP test result to the SPTN value. Okay. Alright, so that is the purpose that you are doing MP test lah, yeah, for your project. Okay, so this one is the value, empirical value for soil. Yeah, so the SPTN value here, yeah. Is the SPTN less than 20? So QU is the ultimate bearing capacity, yeah. I explained already in the previous lecture. QU is the ultimate bearing capacity for your shallow foundation design. All right. So this one SPTN value that's less than 2. So this is the QU lah. Yeah. So when you want to design for your shallow foundation, pad footing or mat foundation, yeah. So you can use this value. Yeah. You can convert the SPTN value to the QU. Yeah. Ultimate bearing capacity. Yeah. To design for your pad footing. All right. Okay. This one explained already. So. All right, so this one is the correlation, the relation between SPT and value, JKR prop, and soil capacity, soil bearing capacity. Yeah, so when you have the blow between 0 to 4, so this is the prop lah. Okay, by example, if you do this JKR prop, okay. You get the value between 0 to 10, meaning that the SPTN value for that particular soil is the is between 0 to 4 lah. So you can start your design. Yeah. So you can refer here. All right. So and then this is the allowable bearing pressure lah. So you can convert here to get the bearing capacity. Yeah. Of your soil, all right. Okay, so this one is the for cohesion. This table for cohesion soil. This table for cohesionless soil. Eh? Non-cohesion soil. Lah. Yeah. All right. So this is the correlation between JKR prop to the bearing capacity. Yeah. So when you have the blow number, okay. Then you can get the bearing capacity value lah. So you can use this one design of your pad footing like this, yeah. Okay, so that's all. Any question? So I will stop presenting the slide. Hey, right? All right, everybody. Off their mic. I know. Your camera. Are you with me or away from your laptop?
I'm here.
Madam, can I ask you something?
Yes.
Say that we don't have quiz today. What will be the fixed time for our class? Because I need to adjust my schedule.
Sorry, can't hear you. Ashraf, right?
Yeah.
Ashraf. Okay.
I want to know the fixed time for our class session. From what time to what time?
Our class will be same as usual lah, 10 to 11:30.
Okay, all right.
But because today we have quiz.
Yes.
I still need to finish the lecture for the soil investigation so that you can do the project. If I don't finish it today,
all right,
then it's delay for you lah to do the project. So that's why I finish.
Thank you.
Okay. All right. Any on the lecture now? On soil investigation. Amirul, you want to ask something? Or Siti Aisha? You have a question, Aisha? No. Is it clear?
Okay.
So, anyone else have a question? So, I'm sorry to take more time, long, out of the stipulated time for your class, eh? Because today we have a quiz, right? So if you don't, if you have question, you can ask you any question. If there's no question, so you, we can end this session, okay? And then see you next Thursday. You know.
Thank
okay,
you,
next Thursday. Next Thursday at 10. All right. I will share the link through Google Classroom, lah. Okay.
No.
Any
no.
question? No question, no, no. Halim, any question? Is it clear? Halim, are you with me? Okay, if there's no question, so we can, you can leave the our meeting now. Okay, thank you so much for your attention. Okay.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you, madam.
Madam, yang pasal projek tu macam mana?
Madam.
Sorry?
Pasal projek tadi madam ada cakap.
Okay, for the project, okay, I will upload the project in the Google Classroom first. Okay, you, you can have a look on the project, okay? And we will discuss the project during the class lah on Thursday. Okay, I will explain on the project on Thursday, yeah?
Okay, madam. Thank you.
Okay? Okay, thank you. So today you have to go through the notes first, understand the SI, only then you can start to do your project later on. Huh?
All right, madam. Okay? Thank so you. Then...
Okay, thank you.
Assalamualaikum. Okay, madam. Okay, madam.